Adriana, were you at Dad's funeral?
Huh? What do you mean why I'm at his funeral? Weren't all of Dad's relatives invited to come?
Stop pretending like he was your dad, Adriana. You're pretending like you were his family during yesterday's wake, too. Do you know how annoyed I was at seeing you?
But I'm his daughter, so I wanted to say farewell to him as well.
Huh? It seems like you have some sort of misunderstanding, but it's extremely rude to sit with his family when you're just an adopted child.
What? I know I was only adopted, but he raised me like his own daughter ever since I was a young child. I don't even remember who my real parents were.
It doesn't matter whether he raised you or not when you're not actually related to him by blood. You're not related to me either. I call you my sister just for convenience, but I don't really think you're my sister, all right? You're always just fucking Adriana in my mind. But I'm the daughter of a CEO, so I can't say such things out loud, right? I feel as if I'm being punished whenever I have to call you my sister, but it can't be helped.
Felia, why were you always this mean to me?
Why shouldn't I be mean to you? Even though you weren't even Dad's real child, he always treated you better than me, his actual daughter for some goddamn reason. But just because I call you my sister doesn't mean you can pretend to be his daughter at his funeral. Dad was always nice to you, but I'm not going to be the same. I'm his real daughter, not you. You're basically just a stranger to him, you know?
I'm sorry. I didn't know you felt like that all this time. I guess it must have been difficult seeing your father treat us differently. But still, what you're saying is just going too far. Just because I wasn't related to him by blood doesn't mean that we couldn't have had a meaningful relationship as father and daughter.
Shut it. Just leave the funeral right now. I don't want to hear any of your excuses. Ugh, I always hated how you were like this. Every time I get mad at you, you always pretend like you did nothing wrong and I'm the bad guy. For once, could you just admit you were wrong?
Adriana, are you alright?
Oh, hi, Irvis. It's fine. I just got a little bit wet. It's not like she hurt me or anything.
Someone saw Phila dumping a bucket of water on you and told me about it. Where are you right now?
I'm at the rental clothes store near the funeral.
Oh, so you rented morning clothes to go to the funeral?
Yep. Someone from the shop saw that Phila had dumped a bucket of water on me and brought me here.
I'm glad things seem to be alright. They're gonna give you new clothes, right?
Yeah, thankfully the owner's a kind person. I also thought of borrowing a wig and some glasses.
What? For what would you need a wig and glasses for?
To disguise myself. So I could sit with the rest of the relatives without being noticed.
What? You don't have to hide like that, Adriana. You did nothing wrong. He's your father.
But...
I'll sit next to you the whole time and prevent anyone from doing anything strange.
What? You'll do that for me?
You're my fiancé. I already got permission to sit with your relatives, so it's not going to be a problem. Even Phila will have no choice but to behave if she's in front of a crowd of people. Don't worry about it. Return to the funeral and say goodbye to your father. Even though you weren't related to him by blood, you were probably closer to him than anyone else in that funeral, even Phila.
Irvis, I wouldn't know what I would do without you. Thank you. I'll return as soon as I change.
What is your problem? Why is Irvis standing watch next to you the whole time?
Hello, Phila. I know you were mad at me, but dumping a bucket of water on my head like that was rude. I would have been glad to settle our differences, but you didn't want to talk to me.
This again. I hate how you always make me seem like the bad guy. You don't seem to understand yet. You're not supposed to be at this funeral. Also, Irvis is supposed to be my fiancé, not yours.
Huh? What does Irvis have to do with this? And what do you mean he's supposed to be your fiancé?
I mean, shouldn't a person who's going to inherit father's company marry the CEO's only daughter? Mom said that as well. And besides, he's too good for you anyways.
Are you trying to say that it's already decided that Irvis is going to be the next CEO? Where'd you get that information?
I mean, isn't it obvious? For some unknown reason, he's engaged to you, who isn't actually related to Father, but it was supposed to be me, you know? This is a good opportunity, so I'll be taking Irvis from you, okay?
That has nothing to do with whether Irvis is going to be the next CEO. What you're saying doesn't make any sense, Philia.
You're so frustrating to talk to. You're going to leave this funeral and Irvis is going to be mine, period. Oh, I almost forgot. There's something Mom wants to tell you. Don't think that a stranger has a right to receive an inheritance, she said.
Sorry, but I'm not going to leave the funeral, and I'm not going to give you Irvis as well. And what's that about the inheritance? Is she telling me to let go of my portion of the inheritance when he was my father as well?
Fine, stay at the funeral if you want. Just know that you aren't welcomed here. Oh, and as for Irvis, I'll take care of him myself later. And yes, that's what Mom is saying. I agree with her, by the way. Why should a complete stranger inherit stuff from my dad, who was a CEO? He probably has a fortune waiting for me.
I don't think this is something we should be talking about the day of the funeral. It's impolite. Dad's will is going to be released by a lawyer after the memorial service takes place, right? The company can't just wait until it's released. So it seems that they're holding meetings to decide who the next CEO is going to be. So I think it's best not to say or do anything stupid for now.
I didn't quite get what you said, but I'm going to take Irvis from you, all right? Irvis himself will probably choose me, the CEO's real daughter, over a complete stranger like you, if he's going to go after the position of CEO.
Well, I guess we are just strangers to each other. I can understand why you don't like me, but it's not an excuse to treat me the way you're currently treating me.
Finally, you understand. It's fine with me, whatever you think, as long as you get out of my life. Looks like you messed up, Adriana. Irvis, the next CEO of Dad's company, is going to be mine now. Too bad, I guess.
But it was already decided before Dad passed away that Irvis wouldn't be the next CEO.
Huh? What are you talking about? What do you mean he's not going to be the next CEO? Hi, Irvis. I'm your new fiancé from now on, so I hope we can get along.
Huh? What are you talking about, Filler? My fiancé isn't you, but Adriana, your sister?
Oh, that's been canceled.
Huh? Canceled? What do you mean?
Dad messed up a bit, so you for some reason got engaged to Adriana. But in reality, you're supposed to marry me, not her. Which is why I'm gonna fix things now that Dad is gone.
My marriage with Adriana has nothing to do with the company's interests, though.
But just a little bit longer and I'll get my hands on Dad's inheritance. If you don't marry me, then the position of CEO is gonna be harder to obtain, you know?
I don't quite follow.
What?
It doesn't matter what you say, my fiancé is Adriana. I have no intention of getting married to any other woman. Goodbye.
What's the meaning of this? Why are you the next CEO? This has got to be some sort of mistake. What dirty trick did you use to make this happen?
Philia, it looks like you're misunderstanding.
What? How am I misunderstanding?
I'll try to explain to you what happened, all right?
Fine, explain it then.
Well, we first need to talk about why your father adopted me.
It's because Mom and Dad couldn't quite bear a child, right? But I was miraculously born after they adopted you.
It's true that they couldn't bear a child before they adopted me, but everything else is wrong.
Huh?
They didn't tell me how much you knew, but it seems that I'm Dad's biological nephew.
What? His nephew?
Yes, I'm his sister's daughter. His sister and her husband, meaning my real parents, suddenly passed away after getting into an accident. So your father took custody of me and adopted me as his daughter. That's what I heard.
Oh, is that so? So does that mean we're cousins?
Yes. About the next CEO of the company, then. Dad's company evaluates people entirely on their skill. It's just a coincidence that the next CEO, me, also happened to be related to the previous CEO. I was one of the employees who were chosen as candidates for the next CEO. And luckily, they noticed my hard work and chose me.
So what about Irvis?
I've been going out with him since I was in the second year of high school. I'm only marrying him because I want to. It has nothing to do with the company.
No way. But I heard that he was competent at his job. He was at least chosen as one of the candidates for the next CEO, right?
I didn't know you had that wrong as well. Irvis isn't even an employee at our company. Where did you even get that information?
Seriously? But I always thought that Dad had brought the two of you together since he was planning to make Irvis the next CEO.
What? You read way too many short stories, Philia. Well, do you understand the situation now? There's a lot of things I need to learn if I'm going to be the next CEO, so I'm quite busy. Bye.
This can't be true. This is completely different to what I thought was happening. Why did I get everything so wrong? Why? Why is Dad's will like this? You inherit all of Dad's property, and me and Mom just get a few gifts.
It's just as the will says. Apparently you're Dad's child legally, but your father was actually a different man, and you were only born because Mom cheated on Dad. I was surprised when I saw this on the will, too. It looks like Dad even has proof that you aren't his real daughter, so there can't be a mistake.
What?
I'm sure Dad was conflicted by this fact all this time. He probably could have divorced Mom whenever he wanted to with the proof that she cheated on him. He could have even threw you away with her since you weren't his actual child.
Huh? So after all this time, you were the one who's related to Dad and not me? Why didn't he tell me about this sooner?
Dad wasn't the type of person to discriminate between us just because of the conditions surrounding our birth. He probably didn't tell us to keep the family safe. Maybe he knew that he and Mother would have gotten divorced. This proves that he did in fact care for you as well, Philia. Because if he hadn't, he would have just left the family fall apart and leave you and your mother to your own devices. You were just too blinded by jealousy to see that he cared for you as much as he did as me. I think what's written on his will is his final decision after years of inner torment, so I'm gonna do as Dad's will says. Goodbye for now, Philia. I hope that one day we can come to terms with each other and be the siblings that we always were.
But if he cared for me as much as he cared for you, then why did he give you more inheritance? I want that money as well. It wasn't supposed to be like this. I was supposed to get rich after Dad died. Irvis, marry me instead of Adriana.
Huh? Phila? What in the world are you talking about? Why should I marry you?
You see, I was such an unlucky child all this time.
Oh, you mean how you ruined your father's actual child? I guess it's a bit ironic how you kicked Adriana out of her father's funeral because she wasn't actually related to him, when in reality, you were the one who wasn't related to your father, and she was.
Yes, I never wanted this to happen, and I can't even receive an inheritance because of Adriana.
What does Adriana have to do with this? Your father simply gave Adriana more money than you and your mother, simply because he thought Adriana would make better use of it, I think. I doubt he was petty enough to give Adriana more money just because he liked her more. It simply isn't good parenting. You and your mother are housewives without a job, right? But Adriana has a promising career. In fact, she's now the CEO of her father's company. And so that's probably why he gave her the money.
But if Adriana never existed, then at least I would have been Dad's only legal child, and me and Mom would have been able to receive an inheritance. Isn't that so?
Philia, do you realize that you're being extremely rude to Adriana?
What? Who cares if I was being a bit rude? I was only telling her the truth. She was trying to lay claim to Dad's inheritance even though she was just a stranger to him. That's why I told her to get out of my sight.
It's true that the business of inheritances can be delayed, and people need to handle them logically. But after your father died, while everyone else was quietly mourning your dad with whatever thoughts they might have had for him, the sight of you and your mother looking so excited for the inheritance was disturbing, simply put. I'm not surprised your dad chose to give his inheritance mainly to Adriana. With that personality of yours, I'm actually surprised he didn't divorce your mother and let go of you sooner. It just goes to show how kind of a man he was.
It's not like that. Dad always treated Adriana better than me, and now I know why. It's because I wasn't actually his real child, and Adriana was his nephew all along. And I never intended for it to seem like I wasn't sad about my dad's death and only cared about the inheritance, Irvis. I was sad about dad's death just like everyone else. You just didn't notice it. And what do you mean that personality of yours? I'm a much better person than Adriana. She just pretends to be the saint when in reality, she just does it to make people like her. And me and Mom are the only person who realize it.
I knew that's what she would say. It's not like your dad ever told me anything, but I don't think that he treated Adriana better than you simply because you were the child of another man. And Adriana was his nephew. Adriana's father was the kind of person to judge someone entirely on who they are as a person. You can see it in how he runs his company, where employees are evaluated entirely on their skill, right? This means that your father was more fond of Adriana than you simply because he liked her better as a person. Although, I will admit that a father treating their children with different levels of love is a bit unfair, and I'll forgive you a little bit for that. But saying that you never intended for it to seem like you weren't sad about your dad's death and that you only cared about the inheritance, it's actually just as bad as saying that you did intend for it to look like that. Because now you're just someone that has no regard for manners and what other people think.
Irvis, don't say things like that. It wasn't my fault that I wasn't actually my father's child and that Adriana was his niece. I didn't ask for any of this to happen. Please, I have no one else to depend on. Why don't you want to marry me?
I feel bad for your situation, but sorry. I'm not going to marry you no matter how much I pity you. Because I love Adriana and no other woman. Goodbye, Philia. I hope that you someday find happiness of your own.
Dad was the owner of the house Philia and her mother lived in, but it was now my house after the inheritance. It seems the two were too proud to live in a house owned by me, so they used the little money they received as a gift from Dad to find an apartment. Actually, the gift money they received was only little compared to the rest of the inheritance, but it was still quite a large sum of money. But for some reason, the two of them decided that these were the funds they needed to start gambling, even though they needed that money to get by until they could start providing for themselves. Even though they intended to earn some easy money by winning, they eventually lost all of it. Now the two of them support themselves by working at a job that comes with housing. But since the two of them have never worked a day in their lives, they frequently make mistakes and get scolded by the other employees. The two now live in poverty and constantly have fights, it seems. Me and Irvis, on the other hand, got married a few months after the memorial service took place, which is also when I started to be more comfortable with my new position as the CEO. We decided to find a new house as a way of putting the past behind and starting anew. And I decided to sell the house I inherited from Dad. I kind of feel bad for Philia. After all, she thought that she was her dad's real child her whole life. But to be honest, I don't think Dad was the kind of person to judge a person based on something like that. So I also feel that what happened to her was ultimately her own doing.
I might be able to take the day off tomorrow. Wanna go house hunting?
Really? That's great, let's go! I am surprised that the president approved your PTO.
He approved it on the condition that I will be able to finish up work that needs to be done urgently within the day. He said that he can come along.
Give me a break. I will thank him from my end, too. We were both so busy, so we couldn't find the time to go house hunting.
But I'm glad he's willing to let us take PTO when we have to meet with the wedding planner about our reception. Oh, by the way, yesterday your mother called me.
Mom?
She asked me if you were able to contact Melissa. Melissa's your ex-wife, right?
Yeah, she is. Ella loved her grandmother, so I know they would like to spend time together, but you know it's complicated. Melissa is so stubborn and refuses to let us see Ella since the divorce. I've had very minimal contact with her. I've messaged Ella as well, but she keeps me on read.
Maybe Melissa is monitoring her phone to make sure Ella doesn't contact you?
Yeah, I think so, but still, it's so strange that she doesn't respond.
You're paying child support, right? Isn't that strange?
Yeah, that's true, but I need to be patient as well. Ella seems to be doing well, so just knowing that she's well is enough for now.
Yeah, that's true. It would be wonderful if you could reunite.
Thank you, Emma. I am so happy that I met you.
Oh, stop it. Makes me blush. Oh, sorry, an external customer just asked a question in our company chat messenger, so I'll talk to you later.
Okay. I'll return after my meeting in the afternoon, so give me a call if you need anything.
Okay, sounds good. Sorry for disturbing you. Can you tell me if Mike works at this company? It is against our company policy to disclose personal information about our employees. This social media account is only for queries on our services. If there is anything that you would like to inquire about, please call our company directly. Please, Mike is my father. I want to see him. Excuse me, your father? Please, tell Mike to save me. Save me? Did you call your father? I cannot talk. I sent him a text, but he hasn't responded. So I'm now in front of the store. What? I have a hearing disability, and I can somewhat understand what someone is saying if I see their lip movements. If you won't believe me, I can show you my school ID, so please help me.
Is it true that Ella's at our office?
Did you see my text?
Just finished the meeting and I saw your text. I don't quite understand what is going on, but Ella is safe?
Yes, she's fine, so please be calm.
Did you ask her what happened?
I heard that she hasn't eaten anything since Friday afternoon.
What? Friday? Today is Sunday!
On the weekdays, she's only allowed to eat hot lunch at school and she's not fed anything else. And on weekends, Melissa usually gives her instant noodles to eat, but they ran out. Apparently, Melissa gets really angry at her if she tries to leave the house, so she was helpless, but she reached her limit.
So Melissa's not home right now. What is she saying?
Yeah, seems so. Melissa went out on Friday and hasn't been back since.
It really is Ella, right?
Yeah, she showed me her school ID, so it really is her. She put in a lot of effort trying to explain to me what had happened. Please come back to the office as soon as possible for her, Mike.
Okay, will do. I'm heading there right now. Talk to you soon. Melissa, I have something I want to ask you about with regards to Ella. I want to talk to you about child support, too.
Oh, child support? Are you going to increase it? Haven't talked to you in a while.
Before we talk about that, I want to talk about Ella.
We can talk about her later.
No.
What? What do you want to know about Ella?
How is she doing? I haven't seen her recently, so I was worried about her. She can't hear, so...
She's perfectly fine. You need to stop treating her different from other people. It's true that she can't hear, but otherwise she's the same as any other kid. I'm raising her the same as I would do with any other kid, so don't worry about us.
What are you talking about? Of course I would treat her different. She is my daughter.
We divorced and no longer have anything to do with you, so stop saying things like that. We know already, you know.
You know what?
I know this is a pretext so you can get back into contact with me. Lol, stop being so needy.
What?
It's been a while since we divorced. You should move on, you know.
Are you kidding? I was just worried about Ella and nothing else.
Yeah, okay. Lol. If you're so worried, why don't you show it in a different way?
In what way?
Child support. The child support that I get now is not enough. Ella is hitting puberty and she eats a lot more than she used to, so the cost of groceries is increasing too. If you could increase it by $500, that would satisfy me.
What? $500? What kind of lifestyle are you leading?
Not just food, you know. I want her to wear nice things too. Like I've always said, you need to be more in tune with women. How many times have I told you this? Give me a break. If you care so much about her well-being, I'm sure you can easily spare another $500. Right, Daddy?
Okay, well then let's FaceTime with Ella. I want to see her face. I want to see her doing well. Then I'll consider increasing your child support.
Okay, sure.
What?
She's in her room, so I'll go get her. Ella says she doesn't want to see you.
Why?
No idea. Maybe because she's hit puberty, she's having complicated feelings towards you? Stop forcing her to see you. I feel bad for making her see you against her will.
Is there another reason why she won't see me?
What?
I'm curious. Where are you right now? Are you even home?
Yeah, I am. So what?
Show me proof.
What? Why? I told you already that she doesn't want to see you.
You could show me a recent picture of her. I am paying child support. I have the right to know how she's doing. So show me.
Why do I need to send that to you? Stop bothering me. Just pay up.
You cannot do this. I will stop my child support payments.
Excuse me? What are you talking about? There's no way in hell you will get away with that.
I now regret it from the bottom of my heart that I didn't fight to get custody of Alpha. I thought at the time that she needs her mother more than anything, so I let you have custody. I really regret it not fighting for her.
Wait, what? Stop being so sentimental and creepy. You need to come to terms that you will be paying child support for the rest of your life. You need to read up on family law. Lol, are you listening? Stop ignoring me. I actually regret my life decisions more than you, especially that I even got married to a low life like you. Our divorce was all your fault, you know? You should come to terms with that and pay up, you know? No, we should not. What? I'm Mike's fiancé. I couldn't stand having you berate Mike, so I took his phone out of his hands and messaged you. What? Fiancé? Mike's? Yes, right now we are with Ella and the three of us are talking to a mediator of the family court. Excuse me? Family court? Why is Ella there with you? Ella contacted us and asked for help. Ella contacted you? If she's with you, it means that you broke into our house and kidnapped Ella, right? You kidnapped her! I will call the police. Send me your name and contact info. No, we did not illegally break into your house. Ella came on her own to our office and reached out for help. She did? On her own? She's deaf, so she can't do something like this on her own. Lol, oh, I see. It's because you don't want to get arrested for breaking into our house. I see how it is. I cannot believe what you're saying to her. Do you even realize what you've done? You left her alone and almost left her to die. She hasn't eaten in 2 days. She was trembling in fear. If she goes out, you will physically abuse her so she couldn't go anywhere. But she doesn't even have food at home to eat, and you didn't come home. This is a crime. She was courageous enough to step outside and ask for help. I cannot even begin to imagine how lonely and sad she has been. I don't even know who you are, but you have no right to tell me what to do about my daughter. I am her mother. I am free to raise her in any way that I see fit. I told her not to leave the house because I don't want our neighbors to judge us. Ella is different and is limited than any other normal people around her, so it's natural for me to treat her as the low life that she is, below that of other children. Have you said that to her face? Yeah, so what does that matter? Seriously? What is the matter with you? She can't hear. I don't even know you, but if you have anything that is causing you stress, you should feel free to yell at her too. It is such a stress reliever. I cannot believe that people like you exist. I'm not even sure how to express how I feel right now. Like I keep telling you, she can't hear, remember? Are you stupid? Ella can lip read, so she can understand what other people are saying. Why do you not even know that as her mother? Imagine if you were in her shoes and the pain and suffering she has gone through to have that being said by her own mother. I have a request. Please, never ever contact Ella ever again. What? I don't understand what you're saying. I'm her mother. You're not her mother. It's already decided. I'm going to look after her. I will take care of her with Mike. Stop acting like her mother. Raise her? Impossible. You don't even have custody of her. Mike will do everything in his power to take custody of her. What? Considering that Ella is very visibly malnourished and her testimony, and I also did some research on your financial situation, you aren't working right now, right? All of the child support and government subsidies that you get for being a single mother, all are used on you and not her. And on top of that, I heard that you were trying to get Ella to work delivering newspaper, and you were trying to get Ella to use her disability to get sympathy from her teacher to get approval to work, and you don't even feed her at home, and you treat her so poorly. When we are through researching and putting together all of the evidence, there is no way that you will maintain custody. Give me a break. You have nothing to do with us. Stop meddling in our family affairs. I am Mike's fiancé. This does concern me. You're so ridiculous. Come on. You think that Mike would fall in love with someone like you? He only loves me. What? Do you know why we got divorced? It's because I stopped loving him. And when I told him, he cried and begged me to stay. I cannot stop laughing when I think about that. He just loves me too much. You're just a replacement for me. If you want to take custody of my daughter so badly, then that would be perfect. I will give you Ella, but give me Mike back. I cannot believe what you're saying. You've never been on vacation with Mike, right? He's good-looking, but is introverted and likes to stay indoors. By the way, I did go on vacation with him once. Oh, about that? That time that you forced Mike to come with you to an amusement park? Lol. You told him, let's go to a restaurant, which then... Mike was forced to go to an amusement park with another married couple that he had never met before. He said that was the worst experience in his life. By the way, Mike and I have gone on vacation numerous times together. He's totally not a homebody. What? He only dislikes public transportation like trains and places that are crowded. We've been overseas for vacation. And we've been on a trip to Colorado. He probably didn't want to go on trips with you because you are so self-centered and selfish. Enough! There's no way that you can win. I have the looks, the perfect body, and great personality. No way that you can win. I want to speak to Mike. He's with you, right?
What do you want, Melissa?
Did you see what she sent? Your supposed fiancé is going to look after Ella for us, so let her do that. When Ella leaves, there will be more space so you can come back. We can go back to when we were newlyweds.
Hey, hey! Stop it! Stop being so creepy!
What? Don't you want to live with me?
I would much rather live in solitary confinement than live with you.
What? Why? You said you love me.
What are you talking about? That is such old news. I want to live with Emma and Ella together.
You aren't going to choose to live with me?
Why would I choose you?
What? Why?
I did love you from our college years and up until we got divorced. And even after we got divorced, I kept thinking about wanting to get back with you. That is not who I am anymore. I think nothing of you, and considering that you have treated our daughter so poorly, I want absolutely nothing to do with you. So disgusting.
Wait, I apologize for what I have done to Ella, so I want you to reconsider.
I told you already. I have Emma already in my life. I'm in love with her, so please stop contacting us.
How am I supposed to live then? What about child support?
I am not paying for your child support. You are not my child. I was doing all of this for Ella. You need to get your life together. You are an adult after all, not a kid.
How can you say that? Can we see each other again? I want to talk things through. Maybe that will change how you feel.
Seeing you won't change anything.
Emma, this is Ella. Thank you for everything today. I just gave my old phone to my dad, and he said that he will get me a new one. Thank you for letting me know. Did you get home safely with your dad? Did you get to see your grandmother? Yes, I did. Grandma was crying a lot after seeing how skinny I had gotten. She kept apologizing for not being able to support me and get me out of this situation. I realized that is what family is about. Very warm. Ella, do you feel happy? Yes, I am. I feel so loved by everyone, like I had a lifetime's worth of love and support. It's all thanks to you. Thank you for believing me when I contacted you. Thank you so much, and I'm sorry. What? Why are you apologizing? Emma, you're Dad's fiancé, right? I heard from Dad. I know you were envisioning a happy married life, but I feel awful that I'm interfering. I'm really sorry. Truly sorry. Please don't deliver newspapers. I forbid you from doing that job. But I will burden you in your lives. Please let me. Please don't worry about the financial burden. You can leave the house and live on your own when you want to. You just concentrate on eating a lot, playing a lot, and learning to rely on us adults more. Really? Of course. Lean on us. Why don't we get some drinks with the three of us? But I'm still in middle school. Sorry, whoops. So we need to go on vacation first then. Vacation? Why vacation? How do I say this? I want you to experience so many different things in life and see all the sights. I want you to get to know me better. And maybe we can go to a hot springs together. Maybe too much for a middle schooler? I think that you might be reluctant to live together without getting to know each other. So just some ideas. These are just some ideas. So Ella, we will do whatever you feel the most comfortable with. Whatever you want to do, really. I want to go. I feel very calm when I'm with you. If you're open to it, of course. I want to live together. Ultimately, Melissa lost all financial support that she had gotten from Mike and all government subsidies. In a desperate attempt, she came to the office to formally apologize As everyone in the company knows about how Ella had contacted us through the company chat messenger, she was kicked out of the building. She failed to pay her rent and electricity bills and was kicked out of her apartment, and she finally found a job working at a factory in the middle of nowhere, is the last of what I had heard about her. As for the three of us, we decided to go on a trip before we lived together. That was so much fun, and it was so nice to see Ella truly enjoy her time there. We are now getting prepared to live together. Ella has recently started asking me if we have plans to have a wedding. Mike is still trying to decide when we will, but I think that we can have a wedding anything, and it isn't the end of the world if we don't have one. I think we have more important things on our list of priorities. I can tell that Ella is not fully relaxed being around me, so I want her to feel more comfortable. And more importantly, I want her to call me Mom instead of Emma.